All of us will have a back injury. It's a normal part of life. Some of you may be worried that these injuries might lead to future back problems. In today's video, we'll be reviewing a study that researched the correlation between previous back injuries and a future disc degeneration. Although everyone's disc will gradually show signs of wear and tear as they age, not everyone experiences pain. Disc degenerative disease is when the patient experiences pain due to a thinning disc. As I often say, it really should not be called a disease, as it is part of the normal aging process. Many who are found to suffer from disc degeneration are genetically predisposed to experiencing pain complaints. However, few studies have researched other causes of the complaints besides genetics. One such study in 2010 investigated disc degeneration in the lower back of identical twins with previous back injury. Why was it important that the subjects were identical twins? Well, identical twins, or monozygotic twins, have the same set of genes. That's what makes them identical. When the father's sperm fertilizes the mother's egg, you get the beginning of a new life, a zygote. In a normal situation, this zygote would traverse down into the uterus and gestate for 9 months. In rare cases, the zygotes split and form two embryos that are genetically identical because they originated from the same sperm and egg cells from the mother and father. In the case of identical twins, because they have the same genes, we can look at the different effects of the environments on their lives. It's a classic case of nature versus nurture. Will the trauma inflicted upon one of the twins result in a significant difference in the progression of disc degeneration later in life? The research found 37 sets of identical twins with different exposures to previous lower back or lumbar injuries and compared their disc degeneration by measuring their disc height and disc signal intensity using MRIs. The disc height gives a good idea of the health of the disc and the progression of disc degeneration. Narrowing of the disc height may represent substantial late-stage disc degeneration and can be linked with a history of back problems. The disc signal intensity refers to the shade intensity of the tissue or fluid. White refers to high signal intensity, and black refers to low signal intensity. You can see the different grades of disc degeneration and how the signal intensity decreases as the disease progresses. Contrary to what the researchers have hypothesized, disc degeneration did not differ between the twins who reported previous back injury and their uninjured co-twins. Both the data from the measured subject's disc height and disc signal intensity showed very little statistical difference when compared with their counterparts. There was no evidence that increased time since injury resulted in a greater difference in disc degeneration. Although more studies need to be conducted, as of now, the current research suggests that a history of back injury is not an important predictor of future disc degeneration. Following the science sometimes presents conflicts to what we think is true. We must keep an open mind, but continue to review, test, and explore what we all consider to be conventional wisdom. It can be uncomfortable and, to some, cause a passionate reaction. But we must let the data guide our conclusions. As always, seek the truth, and eventually we'll find it. Until next time, this is Dr. Shim.